Hello friends, welcome to Study Algorithms, a place where I simplify programming for you with animations, visuals, and some really easy to understand examples. Today, we would be understanding the working of merge sort algorithm. Now, before I begin this video, I want to let you know that a text-based explanation of all the content of this channel is available on the website studyalgorithms.com. Do remember to check out this website if you still have doubts at the end of this video. First, I will tell you briefly about sorting and the advantages of merge sort over the other sorting algorithms. Next, I would do a live demonstration of merge sort in front of you so that you understand what happens behind the scenes. Going forward, we will look at the implementation of the code and do a dry run. So, without further ado, let's get started. If you are new to sorting, I would recommend you to check out the three beginner sorting techniques, that is the bubble sort, insertion sort, and the selection sort, before you start on with this video. I have included those links in the description below. If you already know about them, probably you're looking to learn some more new things, and definitely you're heading in the right direction. Take a moment to congratulate yourself. So, before diving into merge sort, why do you think we needed an additional sorting technique when we already had the concept of bubble sort, insertion sort, and the selection sort? All these three sorting techniques work perfectly fine, no matter what is your input size. So why even bother learning a new technique? Well, you are trying to write code, and as a better programmer, you would expect your programs to run fast, right? Up till now, all the three basic sorting techniques that I have discussed have a worst case time complexity of order of n square. It follows a quadratic growth, and hence, the time taken by those algorithms to sort a set would increase exponentially as your array size or your input size increases. This is a point where merge sort came to rescue. Merge sort has a worst case time complexity of order of n log n. Now, before you start getting more confused with the maths of it, let us dive into the fun part and see how a merge sort algorithm actually works. The best way to understand any concept is to understand it via an example. So, let us take up this sample array and we will try to sort it using a merge sort technique. At the end, we will be sorting this array in an ascending order. So, before we begin, merge sort works on the concept of a divide and conquer algorithmic paradigm. Check out my video on divide and conquer algorithmic paradigms if you are new to this concept. The basic summary of divide and conquer is that you divide a problem into smaller parts and you solve these smaller problems. And once you are done with solving these smaller problems, you would combine all of those results and eventually you would solve your original problem. So, how can we apply that concept in merge sort? So, I have this array, right? So, what I need to do first of all is, I need to do my divide phase. So, as soon as you think about divide, the best example that comes to your mind is dividing it into two halves. So, if I have this array of 8 elements, I can divide it into two parts like this, right? So, this would make two parts like, so you see, I have divided the array into two equal parts. Now, going ahead, these are still not sorted. So we will divide it again. And this time while dividing, I will divide these two new arrays into equal halves. So I would divide the left array like this and the right array like this. Once I have divided them, they will look like so you see, what is happening is, we are dividing this problem into very smaller pieces. Our original problem had an array of size 8. Now we have 4 arrays of size 2. So just think intuitively, it is easier to solve smaller problems rather than solving a bigger problem. But right now, we can do a divide operation once again on all of these arrays. So I can divide them like this. And once I divide them, I get my individual elements like, For now, we have completed the divide phase of our problem and we got individual elements out of the original array. Now let us move on to phase 2 and see how this array eventually gets sorted. You know that it is very easy to compare two numbers, right? You can easily determine which one is smaller and which one is larger, correct? So to conquer this problem, we are dividing our problem into small parts. So I divide my problem like this. And then I can easily determine that 7 is greater than 3, 9 is greater than 5, 8 is greater than 4, and 1 is greater than 0. So in my next step, when I want to combine these elements, I can sort these elements and place them accordingly. So when I place 3 and 7, they would become something like. So you see, a very tiny part of our array just got sorted. 3 and 7 are now in a sorted order. Similarly, I can solve 9 and 5, and they would become. Once again, a very tiny part of the array has been sorted. Similarly, I would be solving the two more remaining parts. Now we have four problems that are solved in itself, but we are moving towards the ultimate solved solution. This time, I need to sort these two arrays and I need to sort these two arrays. So when I would start to merge them, I can see the first element in both of these. Since 3 is smaller than 5, I would keep 3 over here and move my pointer to the next location. Now I compare 7 and 5. Since 5 is smaller, 5 would come here and this pointer would move over here. Now again, 7 and 9. Since 7 is smaller, I move 7 over here and then I'm remaining with 9. So 9 would come over here. And similarly, when I look up my other array, I can point at 4 and 0. So 0 is smaller, so I put 0 and move this pointer over here. Then I have 1 and 4. Since 1 is smaller, I move 1 over here and remove this pointer. I'm remaining with 4 and then I'm remaining with 8. So what I did was I again solved two smaller problems to eventually move towards solving a bigger problem. So now my array looks like. Ultimately, I am left with just two small problems that are sorted in itself. I would again merge them using the same technique I applied a couple of minutes ago, and eventually I should achieve my answer. So when I try to merge them, I would see 3 and 0. Since 0 is smaller, I would be having 0 over here. My pointer moves ahead. I see 1 and 3. Since 1 is smaller, I copy 1 and move a pointer ahead. I see 3 and 4. Since 3 is smaller, I keep 3 over here and move a pointer ahead. I see 5 and 4. Since 4 is smaller, I copy 5. I see 5 and 8. Since 5 is smaller, I copy 5. Now I compare 7 and 8. Since 7 is smaller, I copy 7. Then I compare 8 and 9. Since 8 is smaller, I copy 8. And ultimately, I copy 9. So my array looks like. So now if you just look at this array, this is sorted. And ultimately, after merging all of these small problems, I was able to arrive at my solution. So what we did is, at each of the step, we merged our solutions. In our initial condition, my array size was 1. I merged them to make array sizes of 2. Then ultimately, I merged them to make an array size of 4. And finally, I got my original array that was of the size 8. Now, this is what all happens behind the scenes of merge sort. Let us now do a dry run of the code to see how all of this is implemented. To understand the dry run of merge sort, I am taking the same example array that we just discussed. So on the left side of your screen, you have the actual code to implement merge sort, and on the right, I have my array. So I pass in the input parameters ARR as the array and number of elements to sort. So in this case, ARR is my input variable and the number of elements is 8. Next, do you remember how we stopped when we had just one element remaining? So this is our next condition over here. So if the number of elements is less than 2, that means you just have one element remaining. You can't sort one element, right? And that is why you simply return. Going forward, like we were splitting our array into two halves, right? So the next piece of code finds the middle element and then it creates two new arrays, the left array and the right array. So these array would look like, then moving forward, I fill up both of these empty arrays with the left and the right partitions. So when I fill the left partition, it would come 7, 3, 9, 5, and the right partition would contain 4, 8, 0, 1. Now pause here for a while. So if you remember from our previous example, now this array 7, 3, 9, 5 is a small problem in itself, right? So if I apply merge sort just on this array, then I should be able to get the solution for this, right? And if you see, after a while, when we were conquering all of our steps, we actually got the solution to that mini problem, right? And this was the solution. So you see, 7395 was my original array, and it got sorted to a correct solution, 3579. That means I applied merge sort on a mini problem and I was able to get a solution for that mini problem. Now this thing is true in the case of the right array as well. So if you look, I had my right array which was unsorted, a mini problem as this, correct? So then while conquering all of my steps, I was able to get a solution for that mini problem. Why am I talking about this? Because you can apply the merge sort algorithm recursively on that mini problem to arrive at a solution, right? Going back towards our dry code, if you look at the next step, I am applying merge sort on the left partition. So with this step, I am applying merge sort on this half of the array. And again, in the next step, what I'm doing is I am applying merge sort on the right part of the array. If everything works out fine, then once these two steps are over, my left and right parts should get sorted and they would become. What just happened is these two small problems got sorted and I have two small sorted problems. Now we need to just perform one final step and that is merge. So how merge works is I pass in my original array, I pass in the left half and the right half, and I pass in the starting index of the left array and I pass in the starting index of the right array. So just like the way we did in our example, we would be merging these values based upon the smaller values. So if you compare 3 and 0, you would see that 0 is smaller, so you copy 0 in the main array at the first position and you advance your pointer. Next, you compare 1 and 3. Since 1 is smaller, 1 would move at the next position. This pointer advances. Now you compare 3 and 4. Since 3 is smaller, 3 goes over here. And this pointer advances to 5. Now you compare 5 and 4. Since 4 is smaller, it would go over to the next position. Similarly, so you see, all of these elements will go into their respective positions and then we would get the ultimate sorted array. And this is your answer. The time complexity of merge sort algorithm comes out to be a total of order of n log n. That is because you take n amount of time to scan through the entire array and at each step, you're dividing the array into two parts. So you are doing log n amount of steps. And hence, this is your total time complexity. I hope I was able to simplify merge sort and it's working for you. I just took the example of numbers, but this technique works for any sort of input set that follows a certain sequence. As per my departing thoughts, I want you to understand how much of a difference this time complexity can make. Think about this. Suppose your computer takes 1 nanosecond to complete one step, and your input size is 10,000 elements. In a worst case scenario, insertion sort would be taking up 10,000 squared number of steps, that is equivalent to 100 milliseconds. Whereas, if you are using the merge sort algorithm, you are taking 10,000 into log n number of steps, that is equivalent to 0.14 milliseconds. That is like a 200% improve in your speed. And hence, using merge sort will overall improve the performance of your code. Take a moment to think about the advantages and disadvantages of using merge sort. Could there be any situations when it can fail? How about the time taken for a nearly sorted array? Or what more scenarios can you think of? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and I would love to discuss them with you. Once again, if you found this video helpful, please do consider subscribing to my channel and share this video with your friends. This motivates me to make more and more such videos where I can simplify these programming concepts for you. Until then, see ya.